Hi children, this is Deepika Bhaskar from GK Jain Schools. Today I am going to take class for 3rd standard, subject science, and the topic name is Balanced Ecosystem. Before going to the session, please subscribe our YouTube channel GK Jain Schools so that you never miss any new updates from our school.
Subscribe now and press the bell icon. Never miss an update.
Shall we move on to the topic, children? Balanced ecosystem. An ecosystem is balanced when the biotic and the abiotic factors are cycle the energy and the food as they need. So that is known as balanced ecosystem. That means even a single plant to the big animal. So everyone get their energy as well as their food. So that is called as balanced ecosystem. So the biotic factors included in the ecosystem are producers, consumers and decomposers. All the things in our surrounding, the biotic factors comes under producers, consumers and decomposers. Here, producers. What does mean by producers? Producers are nothing but they make their own food in the presence of water, sunlight and air. So that is called as producers. That means it makes their own food by themselves. We all know that the only one producers in the world is the plants. So that makes their own food in the presence of sunlight, water, air and soil in the process called photosynthesis. So the name of that process is called photosynthesis. On this process it makes their own food. You know children, not all the plants producing their own food. Some plants they feed on their other plants. They feed on their summer plants. That plants are called as parasitic plants. Example for that, cascata. That is an example for the parasitic plant that it won't prepare their own food. Probably green plants that are all produce their own food. So that is why it is called as the primary producers. So the next one is the consumers. What does it mean by consumers? The one who get the food from the producers that are called as consumers. Example for the consumers are rabbit, cow, goat, human, crow. These are all some example for consumer because we are getting the food from the plants. Here plants are the producer and consumer the one who get the food from the producers. So the examples are animals, insects. So for example honeybee, that is also a non-consumer because it's a food for a honeybee is a nectar. It collects nectar from the flowers. It's a one part of a plant. Okay, so consumers are divided into three types. What are they? One is herbivores, another one is carnivores, and the next one is the omnivores. Here, herbivores. Herbivores are nothing but the plant-eating animals. So that are all called as herbivores. For example, rabbit, goat. Rabbit eats carrot. Goat eat grass. Cow eats grass. Donkey, camel. So these are all called as herbivores. They are all called plant eating animals. Next one is the carnivores. Carnivores eat the flesh. So consumers are directly or indirectly, they are getting the food from the producers. They are getting food from the plants. So carnivores, the flesh eating animals that are called as carnivores. Example for the carnivores are lion, tiger, cheetah. So these are all some examples for carnivores. Omnivores. So they are eating both the plants as well as the flesh of the other animals. Example for that, crow, bear. So these are all called as omnivores. It can eat both plants as well as flesh of the other animals. Next, we are coming to the decomposers. Decomposers are nothing but they feed on the dead plants and animals. So that are called as decomposers. That means they won't make their own food. It will always depend only on the dead plants or the dead animals. So that are called as the decomposers. Here, bacteria and fungi. These are all examples for decomposers. Okay, children, now we are going to classify the biotic factors into the producer, consumer and decomposer. Now we are going to differentiate. First one is fungi. Fungi is a biotic factor. Now it belongs to the producer, consumer or decomposer. I already told you, remember that fungi and bacteria are the decomposer. Okay, so fungi, because that organism feed on the dead plants and animals. It cannot make their own food. So that's why it's a decomposer. Next, mango tree. That is a plant. That's a green plant. That is a producer. Okay, so we have to write it in the producer, mango tree. Next, rabbit. Rabbit, it gets food from the plant. So that is why it is a consumer, rabbit. Next, human. Human is also a consumer because food from the primary producer, human. Next, grass. Grass is a one kind of plant. So that is a primary, it is a green plant. So it is a primary producer. Eagle. Eagle is also a consumer. It get food from the producers. Next, cat. Cat is also a consumer. Dog, that is also a consumer. Next, cucumber plant. That's a one kind of plant. So that is why it is also a producer. Cucumber plant is a producer. It makes a own food. So cow. Cow eats grass. So that is a consumer. Crow. Crow is also getting food from the directly or indirectly from the producer. So that is a consumer. Students, now we are going to connect the animals, whether it is a herbivore or a carnivore or an omnivore. Are you ready, children? Cow. Cow eats grass. So that is why it is a herbivore. It eats plants. So it is a herbivore. Next, bear. It is a omnivore. It eats both plants as well as and flesh of the animal. So that is a omnivore. Tiger. Tiger is a carnivore. It eats only the flesh of the other animals. Next, lion. Lion is a carnivore, like a tiger. Lion eats flesh of the animals. Elephant. Elephant eats only the plants. So that is a herbivore. Crow. It is an omnivore because it eats both plants as well as the flesh of the other animals. Okay, children. Thank you.